Good morning, Michele here, mycrazyworkout.com. I have a new workout this morning, Blast from the Past. It's a lot of combo moves. There's gonna be circuits, and each one is gonna have three exercises. We're gonna do it two times through, 10 second rest, 50 second work, and then we're gonna do a 3 minute combination move. And we're gonna loop back around. We're gonna repeat it again before we move on to the next circuit, because it would be crazy if we didn't do that. If you've been a regular of mine, you've seen the combos. If you haven't, I'll go through them as we do them and you'll catch on. It's not that hard. There are five combos and circuits, and then we have a bonus of abs. So abs and butt. So I have my timer, and you can follow along with me, or you can set yours if you're gonna do it by yourself. It is gonna look like, I didn't set it. There we go. So, for the hit for the circuit, the 10 and 50, it's gonna be 10 and 50. There's six rounds because there's three exercises and we're gonna do them two times through. I have my box, sandbag, ball, kettlebell, dumbbells. I think that's all we need. It's okay if you don't have some of this equipment. I'll show you the modifications. If you're a beginner and you don't want to use weight, or you don't want to use elevate your feet with the ball or the bench, you can do it on the floor. It's the same move, you're just not elevating it. By elevating it, it makes it harder, that's all. So you can decide what you want to do. The first circuit is going to be skier hop right and left. It's a burpee and then to a snatch. So we're going to take that weight over our head in one swift move. And then it's gonna be 5 dive bombers, 10 pendulums, and then we're gonna do a frog hop push-up. And when you hop in, you're gonna roll the ball to the other hand, so it's a one-hand elevated push-up. And each time you switch hands, you're gonna hop your feet in for a frog hop. So, you get a 10-second rest before we start. We are gonna do, we didn't do a warm-up, did we? My bad, okay. We need to warm up first. We need to get these muscles going, warmed up before we start. So march in place, sorry about that. I have my gloves on, I moved everything out. I'm warm, it's warm out here today, so it feels nice. It's supposed to get a little bit chillier, so we're gonna heel tap in the front. Heel tap, bend those legs. We're gonna wake up the quadriceps. Tap them to the front. Take the arms overhead. 5, 4, 3, 2. We're gonna pull the arms down. You're gonna pull down, down. We're gonna get some upper body, shoulders, chest, triceps, a little bit of everything in here today. 5, 4, 3. We're gonna toe tap to the side. Right here, toe tap, press out, tap it out, press the arms back, tap it out. 5, 4, 3, 2. Now you're gonna pull down from overhead, pull down, heel kick back, wake up the hamstrings, heel kick back. I saved the bench for last. Olivia's gonna like this one, I know she is. It's in my combo move. I'm sure Conchana will like it as well. I think Daniela, you like those box moves, don't you? Did a little variation on them. 5, 4, 3, give me a knee lift and pull those arms down. Knee lift, hip flexors here. Waist, you got the obliques waking up here, and the abs pulling in. Trying to give everybody a shout out here this morning. Here's 5, 4, 3, march it out. All right, everybody warm? You should be feeling a little tingly. Everything's waking up. All right, so the first one's gonna be with the sandbag. Put your sandbag or your weight, whatever you have. Hands on it, hop into your plank. You're gonna ski hop right, ski hop left, push up, hop in, up and overhead. It's a snatch, right, left, push up. Oh, that was a bad one. There we go. Right, left, push up, hop in, up and overhead. Hit the core. Right, left, push up, up and overhead for that snatch. Right, left, push up, and the snatch. Move that out of the way. We've got 5 dive bombers and 10 pendulums. And we go through until the timer goes off. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Hold it back here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Dive bomber. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and your pendulums. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Dive bomber. 1, 2. No. Okay. Frog hop push up. One hand, right hand is on the ball. You're gonna do a push up, hop in, roll the ball. Push up, hop in, and roll. Now, if you're not rolling a ball, it would look like this. Push up, frog hop. Push up, frog hop. Frog hop. Push up, frog hop. Push up, frog hop. Push up, frog hop, roll the ball. Woo! Okay, back to those. Now, if you have dumbbells and not a sandbag, skier hops. 1, push up. Snatch it overhead and down. Ski hop, push up, and a snatch. Ski hop, push up, snatch. Ski hop right and left, push up, snatch. Ski hop right, left. Oh. Pendulums are next. Dive bombers and pendulums. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now you hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Dive bomber. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Pendulums. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Dive bombers. Woo! Okay. Frog hop push up. Pants are rolling. Push up. Roll over. Neutral spine. Remember, keep that face looking down at those hands. Don't look under the body. We're going to do the combo move next. You get a break. And then we're going to go back and repeat this one more time. Before we move on to the next circuit. Woo. All right. Okay. Your first combo is a ball drop. Let me get the timer set up. Okay. 3 minute countdown. You're gonna do 5 crisscross jacks with the ball. Hold it overhead, drop it and catch it low. Hop over it, 3 low pulse squats. Hop your feet back to the ball and you're gonna do 4 toe taps to the side. Hold for 2 push-ups, hop, jump and turn, and we're gonna repeat the other way. We are doing this for 3 minutes, okay? You'll get it, don't worry. Are you ready? If you're not, take breaks when you need to. 5 crisscross jacks, Olivia's favorite now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold that ball up. Drop it and squat. Hop over. 1, 2, 3. Plant the hands. Hop the feet back to the ball. 1, 2, 3, 4. Push-ups. 1, 2. Hop in. Hop turn. 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold it up. Drop it and squat. Hop over. 1, 2, 3. Plant the hands. Hop the feet back. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 push-ups. 1, 2. Hop in. Hop turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold it up. Squat it. Hop over. 1, 2, 3. Plant the hands. Hop back. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 push-ups. 1, 2. Hop turn. Grab that ball. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Drop it. Ooh, hop over. 1, 2, 3. Hop back. Plank. Press out of the shoulders. Hold the abs tight. 2 push-ups. 1, 2. Hop in. Hop turn. Grab the ball. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold it up. Squat it. Woo, hop over. 1, 2, 3. Hop back. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 push-ups. 1, 2. Hop in. Hop turn. 25 seconds, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Drop it and catch it. hop over it. One, two, three. Hop back. One, two, three, four. Two push-ups. One, two. Hop the feet in. Hop and turn. Whew. Okay. Gotta go back and repeat that circuit before we go on to the next circuit. So, back to, you breathing hard? We're not taking a break. Pause if you need a break. We're going back to those ski hops. Maybe you have a ball or a kettlebell. If you have a kettlebell and you only have one, you can alternate the snatch. I'll show you. You got a 10 second break here. I'm gonna turn it this way so I can still do my push-up. Hands will be on the floor instead of elevated on a weight on your bag or weights. But you go right, left, hop in. Oh, I forgot the push-up. And then you do the right arm, back down, right, left, push-up, hop in, left arm. So you're alternating arms, right, left, push up, right arm, right, left, push up, left arm. You can lay your kettlebell flat if you need to for the push up. Mine gets in the way. Push up, now grab it. There you go. Five dive bombers and then 10 pendulums. Are you sweating? I am. I don't know if it's because it's so humid out here today. One, two, three, four, five. Pendulums. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Dive bombers. One, two, three, four, and five. Pendulums. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Hold that stomach tight when you're in the pike for those pendulums. Okay, now if you don't have a ball and you have a kettlebell, you can do the frog hop push-ups with it and you'll pull it across to the other side. So, push up, hop in, and drag. Push up, hop in, and drag. Push up, hop in, and drag. Or maybe you have a dumbbell and not a kettlebell. Same thing. Just make sure you're looking between the hands when you do the push-up. Don't look back. Back is flat, core is tight. Woo. Okay. Back to that snatch. Right, left, push up, hop in, snatch it up. Right, left, push up, snatch. Right, left, push up, snatch. Right, left, snatch it up. Right, left, push up, give me the snatch. You can do it. That's four, right? One more. Oh, ten pendulums. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10 pendulums. It's really five. It's count each leg. 5. Dive bombers. 1. Ooh. Okay. Frog hop push up. Look at it rolling off of me. Push up. Roll it over. Remember, look down at your hands, between your hands. Don't look under your body. Don't round that back. Hold the core in tight. This 3-minute combo. If you're ready, come along with me. If you're not, take a break until you're ready. We are doing those 5 crisscross jacks. Olivia likes this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Up, ball drop. Drop it, hop it. 3 pulses. Hand, plant the hands. Hop back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2 push-ups. 1, 2, hop it, hop turn. Woo! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Drop it, catch it, hop over it. 1, 2, 3, plant the hands forward, hop back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2 push-ups. 1, 2, hop, turn, grab that ball. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, drop it, catch it, hop over it. 1, 2, 3, plant the hands, hop back. 1, 2, 3, 2 push-ups. 1, 2, hop the feet, hop turn. I can't see my timer for you. 1.5 minutes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Drop it, catch it, hop over it. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 push-ups. 1, 2, hop, turn, grab that weight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Overhead, drop it, hop over it. 1, 2, 3, come forward, hop the feet back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2 push-ups. 1, 2, hop, turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Up, drop it, hop over it. 1, 2, 3, hop the feet to the ball. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2 push-ups. 1, two, hop and turn. Grab that ball. One, two, three, four. Let's finish it. Drop it, hop over it. One, two, three, hop back. One, two, three, four. Hop, turn. Woo! Get to move on. Circuit two. Grab a drink, towel off. Okay, Conchana told me she likes these dumbbell skier swings. We're gonna do that. Then we're gonna go into a three shoulder move. Sort of shoulder and bicep basically. You're gonna do Arnold press, bicep curl with shoulder press, and then you're gonna do regular shoulder press. Okay, 5-5-5 until the timer goes off. And then we're gonna do a reverse crossover lunge with a bicep curl. I brought the 15s out, I'm gonna try 15s. I'll probably do them for the swings, I might have to lower them for the other things. Ready to move on? Let's do it. Remember, we do two rounds the combo before we move on to the next circuit. Skier swings, these are for you, Conchana. So you squat down and you're gonna swing like a skier. Let that weight pull you back. Sit that butt back. You're coming forward by thrusting. Don't swing the arms. Thrust with the hips. And it brings the weight forward. Take breaks when you need to. I'm going to 12s. I don't know that I'll be able to do these accurately if I don't. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. Now shoulder presses. One, two, three, four, five. Back again. One, two, three, four, five. Bicep curl, shoulder press. One, two, hold on to these. Reverse crossover lunge with a bicep curl. Are your arms screaming? Mine are. I'm glad I did 12s and not 15s. You want to be able to press that weight up. Don't swing with momentum. If you're using momentum to get it up, where you're leaning forward and really jerking the weight up, you need to lower that weight. Concentrate on the biceps and the glutes. Swings. This is the second round. You can do it one time through. One. Thrust up with your legs and your hips. Oh, my forearms hurt holding these. Presses first. One, two, three, four, five. Bicep curl, shoulder press. One, two. Now listen, if you only want to go through these circuits one time, I will have them broken off. Shoulder presses. One, two, three, four. Each section will have an orange banner, each circuit. One, you can fast forward and skip the second round of these, of each of these circuits. One, oh, okay. Bicep curl with a reverse crossover lunge. Right leg leads, right leg goes back. Ooh. When you take the right leg back, make sure you're not looking down at your quadricep, because you will lean forward and you will feel it in the quadriceps. If you can lean back and look forward, just think of having a metal rod running down your spine that makes you stay up straight. Ready for the combo? Anything besides these, right? You say that now. Okay, I think Kanchan, I think you had commented on one of my workouts with the warrior gauntlet, and I told you you'd see it. We're gonna vary it a little bit, of course, right? You're gonna do the warrior gauntlet, so you're gonna roll back, and your feet go overhead. You're gonna fling your feet forward and hop into a plank. Two push-ups. You're gonna broad jump forward to your weight, and you're gonna clean and press it to your chest. From there, you're gonna hold it, and you're gonna do, I gotta look here a minute. Oh, okay, two alternating side leg lifts. So, one, two, you're gonna lower the weight down, and you're gonna duck walk back. Two times, because we're gonna go back to the warrior gauntlet. I don't have a lot of space on the mat to be able to roll back. So, you'll get it. Gonna set my weight out here. All right, I'm gonna roll from back here. You just want enough room so that when you come out of the plank push-ups, you want a broad jump forward. So you want a good jump forward. All right, I think I'll move the ball and I'll spread out the towel in case I roll back off the mat. There we go. All right, we ready? It's okay if you don't have a sandbag. Use a weight, or don't use any weight at all. Believe me, you're still gonna feel it. I can guarantee you that. Roll back, come forward, hop into a plank. Two push-ups. Hop up, hop forward. Clean it up, squat, leg lift, leg lift. Down, one, two. Gauntlet back. Fling it forward. Two push-ups. Hop it in. Broad jump. Clean it up. Squat, leg lift. Duck walk back. back. Two push-ups. Broad jump forward. Grab that weight. Squat, leg lift. Down, duck walk back. Gauntlet back. Fling it forward. Two push-ups. Broad jump to your weight. Squat. Duck walk. Gauntlet back. Broad jump. Squat. Alternate that leg lift. Down. Duck walk back. Gauntlet back. Two push-ups. Hop it. Squat. Duck walk back. One, two. Gauntlet back. Two push-ups. Pop it. Squat with a side leg lift. Duck walk back. I can't see my timer. 10 seconds, I think. Gauntlet, let's do this one. Two push-ups. Hop in. Squat. Duck walk back. Whew. Towel off. Get a drink if you need to. Whew. We're gonna go back through. Upper body. Ski your swings are first. Let me set the timer. Are you ready? I think I might go to 12s on these. My grip was slipping there. If it feels too light, I'll go back to 15s. You decide what you want to do. One, two, three, four, five. Remember, squat back. Use those legs to thrust yourself forward. You should just be holding the weights. If you don't want to, Concentrate on contracting the bicep. If you're a beginner and it's too much, you can either stand in place and do the curl, or you can hold the dumbbells and lunge, or you can drop the dumbbells down altogether and just do your reverse lunge. Entirely up to you. Too light, but my forearms are feeling it. I don't know if I could hold tight onto the 15s. Shake out the hands if you need to. My shorts are rolling. One, two, three, four, five. Bicep curl, shoulder press. One, two, three. Alternate front facing shoulder press. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. Bicep curl. Oh, okay. Bicep curl with a reverse crossover lunge. Can you feel these? We still have that warrior gauntlet to do. One more round, and then we'll move, or just that, I should say, and then we'll move on to circuit number three. Change it up for you. Give you something else to fatigue, right? I need to get to the countdown. All right, I'm there. Are you there? You ready? You remember it? Roll back. So fling your feet forward. Hop into a plank. Two push-ups. One, two. Broad jump forward. Clean to the chest. Squat, side leg lift. Oh, down, duck walk back. Roll back, fling them forward, hop into the plank. One, two, broad jump forward. Squat, alternating leg lift. Down, duck walk. One, two, roll back. glass, sliding glass doors. Hop in. Squat on your knee, side leg lift. Whoo! Down, duck walk back. One, two, squat, roll back, fling it forward. Hop into the plank, two push-ups. Hop forward, clean, squat, leg lift. Oh, duck walk back. One, two, minute and a half to go. Halfway there. Squat, leg lift. Duck walk. One, two, roll back. Plank, two push-ups. Broad jump, clean, squat, alternating side leg lift. Duck walk back, roll back, fling it forward, plank, broad jump, clean, squat, leg lift. Down, duck walk back. Again, roll back. 15 seconds. Broad jump forward here. Squat, side leg lift. Duck walk back. Okay. Oh, circuit three. Are you breathing hard? I am. We've got clean and snatch with the right arm. You're gonna left lunge back and you're gonna hold and do a shoulder press. Come up and back down. We're gonna stay on the right. Then we're gonna do the left. And then we're gonna do a reverse lunge, kick front, and then a jump switch lunge. That's our circuit, two times through. Okay? Right arms first, left leg. Snatch it up, lunge it back. Shoulder press and up. Up. Lunge it. Shoulder press and up. Snatch it up. Lunge it back. And up. Snatch it up. Lunge it. Shoulder press. Snatch it. Lunge it, and up. Snatch it, lunge it, and up. Woo! Give that right arm a break. Left arm. Snatch it up. Snatch it up. Oopsie. Lunge back right. And up. Oh. Snatch it. Lunge. Right. Snatch it up. Snatch it, up, press, back up. Whew. Jump switch lunge, right leg first. You're gonna do right reverse lunge, kick front, back, and a jump switch lunge. Right, kick, 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 kick up right, and jump lunge. When you need to. Snatch it up. Lunge and a press. Snatch it and hold. Lunge back and press. By holding it up, when you lunge back, you have to engage the obliques. Challenge yourself. It's okay to open that mouth and breathe. Your muscles need oxygen. I'm breathing hard. Left arm, right leg. Snatch it up. Press, shoulder press. Snatch it up. Shoulder press. Hold the arm out for balance if you need to. Switch lunge. Oh, woo-wee. And we have that combo. Kick front, jump switch. Kick front, jump switch. You're saying, what combo? I'm sure you read ahead. It's the commando combo. Commando push-ups. Sandbag right there. Gonna lay my towel out. Woo! There's a dryer sheet in my towel. Okay, I probably need to move these out of the way because I am gonna have to lay down here for your commando push-up circuit. Gonna slide this out of the way. Gonna start on the right side. You're going to go flat to the floor. You're gonna do a knee tuck push-up right and left. Roll over. You're gonna hold for 10 mountain climbers. hop, broad jump, hop forward to your bag or your weight, and you're gonna hold in a low squat, and you're gonna do 10 pulses. Lower that bag or that weight, hop back to the side that you had rolled to, and start all over again. Alrighty, this was one of Zuzana's original ones. I really, really like this one. I do this one quite a bit, right, left. 10 mountain climbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Grab your weight or no weight at all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Lower it, hop back. 1, 2, roll over. Mountain climbers, don't look under. 8, 9, 10, hop in, hop over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Roll over. 10 mountain climbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If you don't want to do weight, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hop back. 1, 2. Roll over. Mountain climbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hop over. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. One. Roll over. 10 mountain climbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Grab that weight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have one more time through with this circuit, and then we'll move on. You can pause and get a drink. You can curse my name. Take breaks when you need to. I'm drenched. Gonna move the kettlebell back out. Listen, if you don't have a kettlebell and all you have is a dumbbell, it's okay. Dumbbells work too. You're gonna snatch it up. I'll show you. I'll show you with both of them. Let's do this. Here's the dumbbell, because you've already seen me do the kettlebell. I am soaking wet. So you flip it up, you lunge back, and you do a shoulder press. Same thing. Lunge back, shoulder press. Remember, opposite leg. So if your right arm is going up, your left arm, or your left leg is going back. Oh, 5 pounds seems heavy. 5 more pounds from 15 to 20. Whoo! Snatch.
snatch it up, obliques. All right, we got that left arm and jump lunges. We have two rounds and then the combo. Snatch it up, shoulder press. Snatch it up, shoulder press. Snatch it, hold for a shoulder press. Whoops, that was bad. Take breaks when you need to. Right lunge, kick, jump switch. Kick it, jump switch. Kick it, jump switch. Engage the core when you kick forward and when you jump. To launch into the air, you need to engage that core. And if you don't want to jump, you just switch legs. Towards the end. Ooh. Left arm, right leg. I can feel it rolling down my back. Circuit four. Halfway there. You should feel these in your butt as you jump up. Like I said, you can take the jump out. Entirely up to you. Take breaks when you need to. Oh. Ready for the combo? Grab a drink if you need to. Go to the corner, say a couple curse words. Set it up for your combo move. I'm putting my towel down because I don't want a big puddle of sweat for the next circuit. You don't have to use a towel. You might not sweat like I do. Alrighty, right side, commando push-up. Roll over, 10 mountain climbers. Hop up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hop in, hop forward, grab your weight, whatever you're using, pulse up. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Drop that weight and hop back. Right, left, roll over. Mountain climbers, 10 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. My floor is slippery. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hop back. Commando push-ups. 1, 2. Mountain climbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 10. Circuits. See, and then abs are 5. We're going to use the box for this one. We've got a roundhouse kick right. And you're going to hold your right leg out. 2 plie pulses and a plie jump squat. And then you're going to roundhouse kick left. So, oops, wrong thing. You're going to alternate them. Then you are going to do 6 mountain climbers, hold for 2 down up planks, and then 6 plank jacks. And we'll do that until, I keep hitting the wrong thing, until the time runs out. And then we're going to do a boat pose for the abdominals to a hovering pose, hollow pose. And we're gonna do three rounds of that. And then we're gonna keep that box because we are gonna do the combination move with the bench, the box, whatever you have. So move that out of the way. I'm gonna move the box into place. I am gonna put it this way so that you can see me do these, okay? I'm gonna put my towel back here for my feet when I hop back so I don't slide on the floor. I would like some indoor-outdoor carpet, some fake grass so that I don't have this sliding problem, but maybe someday, maybe someday. All right, you ready? Remember, roundhouse kick is first. So you're gonna kick up and over two plie squats and a jump squat. And then we're going the other way. Roundhouse kick, two and a jump. Two and a jump. Am I forgetting a plank in here? Plie jump squat, no, okay. Roundhouse quick, kick, two, and then jump up. Roundhouse kick, two, and then a jump. Roundhouse right, two plie squats, and a jump squat. Roundhouse left, two, jump up. Roundhouse, two, jump up. Woo! Feel that in your hips. Two, jump up. Wow. Okay. I'm gonna go this way. You got six mountain climbers. One, two, three, four, five, six. Down, up, left, right. Six jacks. Four, five, six. Hold it. One, two, three, four, five, six. Down, up, left, right. Plank jacks. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. Down, up, left, right. Plank jacks. One, two, three, four, five, six. Ooh. All right, boat pose. This is boat pose. Hollow pose. Boat pose. Two hollow pose. Boat pose. Hollow it out. Boat. Hollow. Boat. Hollow. Oh, roll it up. Hold boat pose. Hollow pose. Oh, hollow pose. Roll up. Out. Up. Up. I can't see the timer, sorry. Up. Whoa. Okay, we got one more round of these before we do the combo. Now we gotta go back through. How do you feel? Do you feel okay? Take breaks when you need to. Roundhouse kick, two plie, pulse, and a jump up. Roundhouse kick, plie, pulse, jump. Roundhouse kick, plie, pulse, jump. Plie, pulse. Jump up, roundhouse, plie, pulse, jump up, plie, roundhouse, plie, jump up. Whew. Left leg, roundhouse, plie, pulse, jump up. Feel that in your inner thighs and hips. Left leg, kick it over. Ah, mountain climbers, Plank down, up. Plank jacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Down, up, then left. Now plank jacks, hold it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Mountain climbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Down, up, and left. Plank jacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Mountain climbers. 3, 4, 5, 6. Down, up. Plank jacks. 3, 4, 5, 6. Wow. Boat pose. I need a little padding here. My tailbone was starting to hurt. Boat pose. Boat pose. Hollow pose. Boat pose. Hollow. Boat. Hollow pose. Roll up. Pull the knees and the arms up. And then roll back. Arms go overhead. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. Boat pose. Hollow pose. Ready for the combo? Oh, okay. Your combo move. You're gonna do a, on the right side of the bench, step, you're gonna step, or you're gonna, on the left, yeah, on the right side of the bench, step up with your right leg, left knee lift, down, and you're gonna step out wide, and you're gonna do a jack. Man, it's not gonna stop there. You're gonna do, we gotta get to the other side of the mat. So, you're gonna do an up and over. So, let me show this to you. It's gonna go right knee down, squat, and a jack. You're gonna do a reverse lunge. I need to be closer. You're gonna do a reverse lunge. You're gonna step up and straddle the bench. And you're gonna repeat on this side. So you're gonna go up, knee down, out, crisscross jack. You're gonna go right, up. Okay, that's all, okay? 3 minutes. You can do anything for 3 minutes, right? Up, knee, down, jack. Crossover lunge, up, lift. Up, knee, down, jack. Crossover lunge, up. Up, knee. Down, lift, up, knee, down, up, knee. Crossover lunge. Leg lift, straddle, leg lift. Up, knee, jack it. Lunge, up, lift. up, knee, crossover lunge, leg lift. Up, knee, crossover, inside leg, side leg lift. Up, knee, criss cross jack. Up, knee, criss cross jack. Ooh. Lunge it, up kick. Up, knee. Crossover and up. Up knee. Jack. Crossover. Leg lift. Whoa. You know what? We have one more round and we're done. Okay? Abs. Well, bonus abs if you want them. I need a little text in now if you want abs or stop, but I'm not real time, so can't do that. So we'll go with how I feel. All right. Okay. You know this one, right? Roundhouse kick. Then we got the mountain climber pattern. And then we've got goat pose for the abdominals. Right legs first. Right. Plie squat and a jump. Left. Plie squat. Jump up. Woo. Right. Plie squat. Jump up. Left. Plie squat and a jump up. Right, plie squat, jump. Left, plie squat. Go low if you can. Feel it in the hips and the inner thighs. If you're holding weights and you're only going like this, you're really only getting the quads. See if you can go low. Get those hips, get those inner thighs. Oh. And those quads. Mountain climbers. Plank position. Press out of your shoulders. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Don't look under the body. Look down between the hands. Plank jacks. 3, 4, 5, 6. Mountain climbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Down up. Engage the core. Plank jacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hey, if you don't want to jump, 3, 4, 5, 6. Down up. Left, right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? No. Goat pose to hollow pose. Goat pose to hollow pose. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Goat pose. Hollow pose. Goat pose. Hollow pose. Hollow pose. 1, 2. 1, 2. When you do your hollow pose, make sure that your lower back is in the floor. If that means that your legs are up a little bit higher. That's okay. You don't want an arch in your back. And then what we have, one more round through, right? We are almost done. Right legs first, roundhouse kick, two, and a hop. Roundhouse kick, two, and a hop. Roundhouse kick, two, and a hop. Oh, I feel that in my hips and my inner thighs. Oh, roundhouse kick, two, roundhouse kick, two plie, and a jump squat. Right, left, right, and a left. Woo! Mountain climbers are next. Oh, we're almost done. Come on. Finish strong. Three, four, five, six. Down, up. Now left, right. Plank jack. One, two, three, four, five. Mountain climbers. One, two, three, four, five, six. Down, up. And left. One, two, three, four, five, six. Mountain climbers. Four, five, six. Down, up. Down, up. One, two, three, four, five, six. Mountain climbers. One, two. Boat pose to a hollow pose. Now listen, if these are too much and you're a beginner, stay on the floor and just pelvic tilt. Concentrate on pushing that back into the floor. Push your butt towards your heels and pelvic tilt. You don't have to do bow pose to hollow pose. Work at your fitness level. You gotta work on contracting the abdominals. So if you need to plant your feet and focus on that pelvic tilt, you press your back into the floor and you pull your butt towards your heels is the best way I can explain a pelvic tilt. You're not lifting it off for a bridge. You're literally pushing your tailbone towards your feet, if that makes sense. All right, last time with the combo move, and then we'll finish out with abs, and I'll give you a really good stretch. We need a really nice cool down. If you're gonna stick around for the cool down, I recommend that you do, but not everybody does. So it's your preference, but remember, you work your muscles to build them. You also have to work them to stretch them. They don't stretch themselves. All right, you remember this? Cross over, up knee, down, jack. Crossover lunge, leg lift, and alternate and cross over to the other side. Up knee, down. Oh. Crossover lunge, leg lift. Up knee, jacket, lunge, alternate. Up knee, jack, lift, up knee, on the clock. Lunge, leg lift. up, jack, crossover lunge, almost forgot what I was doing, up, knee, crossover, leg lift. Up knee. Up knee. Up knee. Jack, reverse, step, up, lift, up knee, jack, reverse, up, lift, grab a drink, towel off. Okay, we have 7 abdominal exercises, and that's it. We're gonna do a right side plank. I'm gonna slide this out of the way a minute. You're gonna do a knee tuck to a front kick, and then you're gonna do a left side plank, knee tuck to a right kick. We're gonna do 10 of those. And we don't need a timer for this one. So, get in your right side plank. Make sure that your hand is lined up with your shoulder. Knee tuck, kick. 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, take breaks when you need to. 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's do that other side. Knee tuck, kick. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, we've got right leg in the air, left glute lift. I'm gonna elevate mine, you don't have to. So, glute raise, roll up. This ball might, I think the ball is too high. I think Olivia said she did it. I have to figure that one out. Okay, glute lift, raise up, and left hand to the right knee, or to the right foot, right hand to touches back. 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9. Ten. Right leg down, left leg up. Glute lift. Roll up. Right hand to the left leg. Left hand goes back. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. 10. All right. Now we've got a plank again. You're going to elevate your feet onto the bench. You're going to do a right side plank. So, let's see. I'm going to switch it around here. Right side plank. Put that left leg up, right leg is down. 1, 2, if you want to reach out. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If you don't want to elevate, if you're a beginner, you can do it on the floor. Left leg would come to the front. You'd go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10. Bridge squeeze. Lay down on the back. Ball or whatever you have that can go between your legs, a block, a ball. My legs are sweaty. Hold it up and squeeze your legs together. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 more. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, can we do it one more time? I know, I just heard the You don't have to if you don't want to. But now that you have it, right sides first. Knee tuck, kick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Whoo! 7, 8. 9, 10, roll over, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh. Glute raise. Right leg's in the air. Lift, twist. 2. 7, 8, 9, 10. Left leg. Left arm's going back. Right arm to the foot. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10. Plank, you can either elevate or you can stay on the floor, it doesn't matter. Right leg's pulling in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You should feel that right there. I'm gonna turn and my back's gonna be to you, sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Glutes and thighs. Put that ball, weight, block, or if you don't have anything, it's okay. Hold it up, squeeze that butt. Squeeze the thighs in together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, wow. That's it. You're saying, really? Is that all? Are you ready for a cool down? I am. We need to open up those hips. They're really, really tight. Mine are anyway. Okay, so this one was a little bit long. You're gonna save this one for a weekend or a day off work. This one was an hour and 40 minutes. Now, mind you, I was talking and I was explaining. So, and according to my watch, I burned 687 calories. I believe it. This was killer. This is a killer workout. I had played around with it at the gym and it didn't seem too bad, but I didn't do a full run through on it. I just played around with the different moves and thought, oh, these will work. Should have tried it out. Okay, come down onto your hands and knees. I want you to take your feet wide, or your knees wide. We're gonna go into a frog pose. It's like a child's pose, but you're gonna go down and you're gonna sort of sit back, but you're gonna walk your hands out. You want your pelvis to be lined up with your feet. You don't want them to push back past your feet. You wanna feel this in the inner thighs and in the hip flexors and the outer parts of the hips as well. If you can, you can take your head down to the floor. You're in a frog pose, so if you're not doing it right, it'll be more like a child's pose where you'll sit your butt back to your heels. I don't want your butt sitting back to your heels. I want your groin to be coming down towards the mat. So it's gonna sort of hover in that position. And just hold it here. If you can, lower your chest to the floor. If you need to put something under there to bring the floor up to your chest because you can't go that low, it's okay. Grab your ball, grab a blanket. Is my ball close by? You'd literally take the ball and you'd set it underneath your hips so that when you sit back, your hips are resting on it. I like to feel it stretch out. So I like the fact that I can feel that pull through my pelvis and my hips And I like to feel that stretch. It's not a child's pose, but you're gonna bring your chest down to the floor. You should feel it in your inner thighs. Your butt's gonna stick up in the air a little bit when you do this one. Wow, they're tight from the, just from everything. Not one specific thing, but I could really feel them on the plie pulses and on the last circuit. Okay, release it, come up. Now I want you to bring your knees out and your feet together and sit back into child's pose. Now we're in child's pose. The butt is gonna go back towards the feet and you're gonna feel it more in the outer parts of the hips and in the glutes. Just breathe. If you can take them wider, go ahead. If you want your hands wider, you can take your hands out wider, or you can keep your hands close. If you can, drop your chest down to the floor. Feel that stretch. We're gonna pull through on this one, and I'm gonna have you come into Sphinx pose. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna pull through, and you're gonna bring your legs out back, and you're gonna hold right here in Sphinx. So elbows are lined up with the shoulders, and you're holding your abdominals in, and you feel that stretch in the lower back. Now we're gonna take it to an upward facing dog. So you're gonna bring your hands back to where your elbows were, and you're gonna come up. And you can hover on your feet, or you can keep your legs on the floor. You wanna pull your shoulders down and pull your chest out. Don't hug your shoulders up at your elbows. You want to open up that chest. Now we're gonna stay right here. We're gonna come back down to the floor. My arms are really, really tired, and I'm sure yours are too. So you're gonna bring the arms out to the side. We're gonna roll over onto the right side, and you're gonna bring that left arm up, and you're gonna reach it over towards the right side. Now you should feel a nice stretch in the hip and the thigh, and you should also feel this in the shoulder on the right side. And you're gonna release it. Bring the hand down, roll back over, roll up, upward facing dog. Stretch out the abdominals, pelvis, hip flexors. You should feel a nice stretch through the front of the abdominals. And release it, drop it down. Hands go to the floor, and you're gonna roll over onto the left, or the, the left side. And the right arm is gonna cross over, and if you can touch it to the right, if you can touch your right hand to the left, awesome. If you can't, just reach it back there. Feel that stretch, open up the chest. Feel that stretch in the shoulders. Keep that foot planted on the floor. Feel that in the hip and in the groin. And release it. Roll it back over. The swimming pool is kicking on. The gurgling you hear is the solar is that it's circulating up onto the top of the roof and dumping into the pool. Raise up. Upward facing dog. We're going to press back into a downward facing dog. Press it back. Press the feet into the floor. Press the hands into the floor. What I want you to do is I want you to bend the knees, press the chest back to the thighs as far as you can go. And then straighten out those legs. I want you to come back, bring the right leg up, bring the right leg over, three-legged down dog, line the hip up. And you're gonna pull that right leg forward into pigeon. Now, with pigeon, if you're flexible, you can have your leg on a 90 degree angle, but you don't wanna roll onto the right hip. So, I'm not that flexible. I keep my right leg back by my pelvis, and that way I stay up on the quadricep of the left leg, and I feel a nice stretch in that right glute area. Now I'm gonna take that left hand and I'm gonna thread the needle. So I'm gonna cross it under my right. And then you should really feel a pull in the glute, but you'll feel a nice stretch in the shoulder as well on that left side. But I like this because it forces you to stay up on those legs and really feel it in the glutes. You're not rolling over onto the right side. You are really getting a stretch in the piriformis, which is the muscle deep in the glutes, and the sciatic and the hips. Just breathe. Open your mouth. Inhale. Exhale, blow it out. Again, inhale. And exhale. Bring that right hand back. Press up. Press up into the hands so that they're on the floor. Round the back. Arch the back. Feel a nice stretch in the hip flexor on the left side. We're gonna swing that left leg around and you're gonna kick the right leg out. Now we stretch the back. Now we're gonna stretch the front of the right leg before we go on to the left. So bring your left foot in for a figure four. You're going to come down so that your chest is on the knee or on the quadricep, but you don't wanna round the back. You wanna keep the back flat. If you can, cross that left hand over to the outside of the right knee. Feel a nice stretch down the left side. And just inhale. Raise up. Exhale. See if you can lower down a little bit further. There is a slight bend in that right knee and you're getting a nice stretch through the hamstring and up into the glute in the back. But you want a nice hamstring stretch here. And you want that chest to be lying on the quadricep, so on the front of the thigh. The longer you hold it, the more you'll feel your muscles relax, and you'll be able to go further and stretch a little bit more. The initial thing, when you go forward or you do any stretch, immediately your muscles grab and sort of lock. You have to hold that stretch for like 5 breaths before you'll start to feel it release. So this is really awesome if you can do it in the evening before bed. If you can just do some stretching, it's always great. And release it. We're going to swing those legs back around and come back into a downward facing dog. And we're going to do the same thing. Bend the knees. Press back, press the butt into the air, and then you're going to straighten those legs. You're going to bring that left leg up, down, and you're going to do a three-legged down dog. And you're going to line that knee up with the hip. Nice stretch in the obliques. And you're going to pull it forward into a pigeon. Again, if you're flexible and you can do a 90 degree angle with your leg without rolling out, see how I roll out. But if you can't, it's okay. The next best position is with your foot down at the pelvis and you're going to walk out. Now take that left hand and thread that needle. Bring that right hand underneath the left and you'll feel it raise up so that your hip hip flexor, your pelvis is resting on the heel of your left foot and you're on the left leg, like the shin, so that you feel that stretch in the glute and the piriformis on the left side. You don't want to be rolled over like this. You don't really get that stretch. So you want to stay up on the quadricep and you want to feel that stretch. And if you can, lower the head down to the floor. Nice stretch here. Just hold it here and breathe. Okay, now you want to release it. Bring the hand back, pull the hand out from under, and you're going to slide that right leg around into a figure four. Left leg is going to go out. I think it was Danilo that asked for an Easter. I think it was, or it might have been Daniela. Somebody asked me to repeat or do something with the Kill the Rabbit, the Easter workout that I did last year. I worked on it yesterday. I have one set up. They wanted me to do an exercise for each letter, Happy Easter. So I did that, and then I have some circuits to finish out with. So that's going to be the Easter one. I think is that next week? I have to look and see. But I have that one ready, pretty much ready to go. So I look forward to doing that one. It's a little bit different, just like today's. Today's was really different as well. Thanks for all your input. I enjoy it. I like giving the challenges and doing different things. I like hearing what you like so that I can throw it in there or put it into a combo move and make it even better than just by itself. Release it. We're gonna pull back up. Bring the feet together at the heels. And you're gonna press the knees out and feel that stretch through the groin and the pelvis. And you can, if you can pull in on the ankles and take the elbows and press down on the thighs. Nice stretch. You're gonna take the left leg out and you're gonna cross the right leg over. Bring the left arm around the right leg and bring the right arm to the back. Twist around. You should feel a nice stretch in the hip, but you should also feel a stretch in the back. Try and look down at that right hand and try and pull that right shoulder back. Release it, come forward, cross the left leg under, fire log pose, and you're gonna fall forward, feel a nice stretch right here in the hips. Ah, I like this pose. I know, what one don't I like, right? You'll have to correct me. I don't know if it was Daniela or if it was Danilo. One of you guys had asked if I have to go back and see if I can find it, but I have the Happy Easter one as requested, so it should be a good one. I'll make sure I get it up before I cross those legs before Easter. And the right leg goes out, the left leg crosses over. Bring the right arm over to the left knee and bring the left hand behind you. Look down at that hand and look over that chest or over that left shoulder. Open up that chest. And release it. Cross that left or that right leg and that left leg into fire log pose and drop over. Now, some people are really flexible. You want to make sure you keep your hips on the floor. So when you drop down, you don't want to be lifting the butt off the floor. You want your sit bones on the floor. Some people are so flexible they can put their head on the floor. I can't do that. I can feel the stretch right here just by resting my chest on my legs. You might be here and you might feel the stretch. It's okay. It's wherever you feel comfortable. So if you're here or here or here, that's okay. I have one more stretch for you. It's for your shoulders and your arms. We're going to finish out with Eagle Pose. Come back up. If you want to, just sit cross-legged. You're going to take the arms out. You're going to fold the right arm under the left arm. Interlace them, hands together. You're going to press forward with the arms and lift up. You'll get a nice stretch through the back and through the shoulders. And just hold it here and breathe. And then we're gonna switch the feet and the hands in a minute. Uncross those hands, unfold those legs, bring the right leg up, bring the arms out, cross the left arm under, loop them around. You're at shoulder height, press them out and feel that stretch in the back, and then lift them up. Now when you're sitting here, remember, hold that stomach in. You want to have a flat back. You don't want to be slouched like this. You want to be sitting up. Concentrate on training the stomach to stay in, holding it in. And release it, shake it out. Pull that right, take that right hand, pull up on that left, stretch out that shoulder and the oblique on the left side. And then come back up, take that right hand and pull over to the left. And shake it out. That was your workout for the day. I know this one was a long one. I hope you enjoyed it. Leave your comments below. Thumbs up it if you like my video. Please subscribe to my channel. Tell your friends about me. And we'll have the full breakdown below the video. And like I said, I have the Happy Easter one ready to go. I will get it up and ready before Easter so that you can burn off all those candies and treats that you're gonna eat. Have a good day, and I'll see you soon.